Question 8 part 2 asks you to express the fraction in partial fraction form. So first thing, just quickly organize your fraction from largest power on the left. So 5 squared will be on the left, 11x followed by 6. Now just write the rest. So at this point, I just like to take a pause. So for partial fraction, just be very mindful. If the largest power at the top, in this case it's 2, right? As compared to the largest power at the bottom, being 3. Let's make a comparison. If the, let's say, top being power at the top, and 3 being bottom. If the top number is less than the bottom, then all you have to do is just go ahead and use your partial fraction all along. Plus something. Let's say a over x plus 2 and b over x minus 2, for example. But however, if the top itself is the same, or I'm using a few short codes here, top equals to or, if it's more than the bottom, then keep in mind that you must actually use a long division first, so that you get a whole number here. For example, you get 2, then you get plus the rest of it. So in this case, let's give it some numbers. If the bottom is still 3, for example, and the top is 2, then here you can actually go ahead and use this partial fraction straight away. But if it's the bottom is 3 in this case, and for example, the top is actually 3, then you must actually go on and do a long division. Or if the top largest power is 4, let's say over here, it's 4, and here it's 3. That's when you can actually use, you must actually use this long division method to get your whole number first. Quickly go back to the main question itself. Here, you must find the denominator form. Quickly look back to like question 8 part 1, and you can see that what we had gotten was the quotient x squared plus 9. So in question 8 part 2, you can actually get that this is x squared plus 9 somewhere, and 3x minus 1 on the other hand. So you can quickly let the rest be this fraction be as followed from your formula booklet or whatever you can remember. A over 3x minus 1 plus b over, sorry, since it's x squared plus 9, the square itself, you're gonna be bx plus c. So if you quickly refer to your formula booklet of my textbook, you can actually see this table itself. So you can see what you want is x squared plus 9. So you have x squared. This may vary a bit here and there, but just keep in mind it can be different. So you have x squared. And lastly, x squared is here. So you have bx plus c. And quickly get to the rest. Okay, I'll just run through quickly why it can't be used the other two. Here again, there's no x squared, so you can't use this. And again, the square outside here, which is deceivingly is outside of the bracket. So unless the square is here, over here at this region, then can use that formula. But otherwise, no. Remember, just keep on to your this formula itself. And so from this step, what we're doing is we multiply every single fraction. So over here, there's one. One fraction, second fraction, third fraction, multiplying every single fraction by 3x minus 1 and x squared plus 9. Since in this case, these are two denominators, brackets that we must multiply off. So once we do that, from here we're left with, since we multiply off 3x minus 1, the whole denominators, left and x squared minus plus 9, the whole denominator is cancelled off already. So for this case, You multiply 3x minus 1, you cancel off here. Multiply by x squared plus 9. There's nothing here to cancel off at the bottom, so it's x squared plus 9. And here, bx plus c. So be careful with your brackets, since there's two terms. X squared plus 9 cancels off, there's 3x minus 1. And so, over here we sub in numbers, like let x be something or something. So, okay, I've no enough space, I'll try and open. Actually, I didn't open a new page. Let me scroll down a bit. Oh, still jumping. Alright. Just clear. Multiply off the denominator. And the fourth itself, let's do subbing x value. And now you'll be doing the fourth stage itself. Let's see, what number can you sub in here such that you can cancel off a certain value? Okay, ultimately what I want is to cancel off. Sorry, ultimately what I want is to get A, B, and C. So first thing we solve, we have to cancel out two values, either B, C, or in such a way that we only have one. Okay, let me run through this. What we can do is here, right? We try to make it B0. And boom, there you have it. A 1 over 9, because x being 1 over 3, so x squared is 1 over 9 plus 9. And here you can actually just write plus 0, since 0 times whatever number here, let's say 5 or 6, whatever number it is, it will always, this whole chunk, it will always become 0. Yeah, actually, you can don't even write this at all. And to evaluate, it's straightforward. So I'll skip this part. So with your calculator, you should be able to magically get this number where A is equals to 1. So let's quickly go on to the next step. So quickly, now that we have found your A value, we're left with B and C, right? So what you have to sub x again such that you can eliminate one of the x values. In this case, which one do you think is easier to eliminate? Seems like a bx can be eliminated, right? When x is there, this will be make this x be 0, then b times x will give you 0. 0, and such that c will be the only number that's left to go along with. Once again, this may take a bit of practice, but once you just get through like 2 or 3 questions, it's much easier. So what's easy to solve? Let x be 0. So I'm going to speed this up once again. A being in found already, so it's 1. The rest being bx in found, is make x be 0, so it's 0 plus c minus 1. So there you have it. C actually exists. And here, 0 is a very easy number. So 6 plus 9, 6 equals 9, plus minus, so you have minus c. So c, move it to the left. It'll be C is equal to then 6 move to the right, you get C is equal. And so quickly, let's just look back into here. We have found our A, we have found our C. So what we left with is just B. So A already know that it's 1, C you already know from earlier. Here that it's actually a 3. So it's very straightforward now. I'll just quickly go through. I'll just bring this to the bottom. And there you have it. The easy way is just make sub x be here. Something that I haven't used before. So earlier we used... x equals 1 over 3, and we used x equals 0. So we use this another easy number, sub x equals to 1. Then, ta-da, magic happens. There you have it. And simplify. Minus 5 plus 11 plus 6. This error. There you have minus 4 is equals to 2b. B is equals to negative. And that's your answer. So just one last working itself. We have found that a Therefore, just one last statement. We have it, A being 1. Let's go up so we can have a look. A being 1, B being minus 2, and C being 3. And this is your answer for 8 part.